Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In this tutorial, we'll be creating, looking at how we can create brushes for Photoshop. And further, we'll look at how to create pattern. We'll be creating brushes for pencil sketches. And here are some of the sketches I prepared. So we'll be creating those sketches to brushes. And these brushes are going to be dynamic. It's going to be fun. So let's look at how you can use this tutorial to create your own brushes. To import these sketches to Photoshop, let's open a new document. I'm taking a big size document because we want our brushes to be huge, so that if you want to apply it in a huge canvas or something, it wouldn't lose its details. So I'm taking 4000 by 4000 here, and let's create the document. So first of all, I import the image. So I'll import this one, and on the image I'm looking forward, I'll import this. Okay, I'll choose this one as well. So let's start creating the brushes. So I'll be selecting few of the sketches from this one. Let's choose, okay, let's select this first. I'll hide all the other layers. I'll choose this one. So first of all, let's increase the brightness of the image. So I'll go to image, adjustment and level, and over here in this panel, let's increase the brightness. So I'm making sure that the background is fully white and only this sketching part is visible. Make a selection of this brush and we'll create this in a new layer. So for that, I'm using the shortcut Command or Control J to create a new layer. And if I had the main layer, you can see we got only this image. So now I'll do little more changes over here. First of all, convert this into smart object, and I'll scale up the size according to the document size so that we get a big brush. And I'll again go to image, adjustment, levels, and let's try to remove all the gray region. This, so I'm just sliding it up a little bit, and as you can see, we got a fully bright background in the back. And now click OK. As you can see, it's a smart object, so I'll convert it into rasterized layer, and you go to image, adjustment, and desaturate. Just desaturate it, and it will convert it to black and white. Now using the selection tool, select the region. Now go to edit and define brush preset. So click on it. This way you can create your new brush. Let's give it a name, thick line, and click OK. So here we got our brush. Now next thing I want to show here is how you can give some dynamic effects to your brush. So I will just hide this layer, create a new layer, and if I go to brush, open our brush panel, you can see our thick line brush is created over here, and you can apply it very easily. So I'll open this brush settings, and we got some few options over here. You can do lots of settings in here. So the first is brush tip shape, where you can decide the spacing. So if I draw like this, you can see my spacing is very less. So if I increase the spacing, you can draw your brush in certain distance and it will apply like this. So for this brush, I'm setting the spacing to around 25. That's a decent spacing. And I'll go to shape dynamic, and over here the first thing is size zitter. Over here I'll be adding 40% so that I can give some size randomness. The second thing I will be touching over here is angle jitter, because as you can see, if I reduce the percentage, there's not enough change in the angle of the brushes. So let's give some random angle. Like if I draw one brush over here, the second brush will act in a different angle and it will give randomness to your design. So this is the first setting, and our first brush is ready. The next step you need to do after creating your brush, go to brush. Here's the thick line. For example, if you want to save this brush for other projects, then the best thing you can do is go to here, settings, preset manager, and over here just select the brush. Here is the brush we have just created, and save sets. So it will save all the settings which we have just applied. And let's give it a name, choose your destination, name it, and just save it. Now you can use it anytime you want. For example, your new Photoshop file doesn't have this brush. You need to do is just open the brush, open the panel, go to settings, preset manager, go to load, and go to that destination where you have placed your brush and just open it and load it, and it will be there over here like this. So it's very simple to create any brush. For our collection, I'm going to create 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 brushes together. And this brushes, we're going to use it in our next tutorial. Well, I'm going to create a sketching, photo sketching effect. And for that, I will need these brushes. So let's begin. The second brush which I'm planning to create is line. So let's create out a line. I'll go to image again and let's look up for a line. So I have got few lines over here. Let's choose a nice line which we can use. I think this long line is looking very good. So let's use it for our design. So let's again do the same process. I'll use the selection tool this time because we need to select specific area. So just draw the area where you want to select like this, and selection is done. Now what is the next step? That is Command or Control J. So Command or Control J to duplicate, and it will be created in a new layer. Hide our main layer, and we got our line. Now the size is very small, so let's increase its size. And to make sure that the details are not lost, I'm converted into smart object, and Command or Control T, scale up the size. I'm just making sure that it's perpendicular. Now to create this into brush, before that, as you can see, we have got some shadings over here. Let's remove it. Let's convert this into rasterized layer, image adjustment levels, increase the white balance, as well as let's increase the darkness of our pencil a little bit so that we get all the details in our image like this. Now using the selection tool, click and drag it down to make a selection. And now go to edit, define brush preset, and here let's type out the name line. And as you can see, I got a new brush. So the next thing we need to do is do some settings for this. I want to give some different effect to this line. So I'll go to the settings again. So you go to brush. Here's our line. I'll go to here, brush settings. First thing is spacing. So let's keep it default 10%. Let's add a new layer to work on it. Now under shape dynamics, if I draw it out, you can see it's drawing it very randomly. Let's change it to pen pressure. This one, angle jitter, I'll reduce it to 0. And direction is there, angle jitter is there, pen pressure is there, and pen pressure. Okay, let's see what's the problem. Just found out what was the problem. The problem was not that much big. It was very simple. Let me bring out my brush and let's select that brush, line brush. Right now my brush is acting horizontal. So over here, just change the rotation, and once you draw it, you see you can apply it in straight line. Let's draw like that. Like if you want to draw a line, you can draw it out. That's like this. So it's very simple. If you want to apply a few of the lines, just click and it will draw random lines. If you increase the roundness jitter, you can see that it will give you more freedom. Like some are straight, some are little random. So it will give you that effect as well. I think I'll keep it around 50, and it will give you line as well as some random curviness. And after you have completed that settings, we'll go back to brush over here. This is our line. I will save this in the form of brush. So I'll go to preset manager, and over here we'll select that brush and save it. Let's give it a line name and save it, and done. So our second brush is also done. For the third brush, I'm making light lines. So let's look at on the image. So let's increase the levels over here, brightness a little bit. Like that. Okay, let's keep it like this. Make a selection using the selection tool, Command or Control J, create a duplicate, and I'll go to image adjustment levels, and let's, so for this we are giving a very light shade, and click OK. Now to create this into brush, just select, make a selection, go to edit, brush preset. Let's give it a name. Okay, Command E, and I'll hide this layer, and here is our new brush. We'll do some settings. I'll go to settings over here. For the dynamics, we'll keep it around 40, same. And for angle jitter, let's give it around 10. Let's reduce this to 0. And under scattering, we'll give around 100. Then under transfer, we'll increase the opacity to 50. And that's all. So it will give you some random opacity in the effect as well. And let's save it. For the fourth, we are giving some sketching effects. So I'll choose this one. Let's adjust the contrast by using the levels. Let's increase the brightness. Okay, I'll make a selection, hide the layer, image, adjustment levels. Okay, and if you see some patches over here at the corners, you can use eraser tool. Now make a selection and create a new brush preset, sketch lines, and okay. So our next brush is also ready. So let's do some setting for this. So I'll go to brush settings under dynamics, change it to 40 and the scattering 50. So let's see how it works. Angle jitter to 10% and it will give you that randomness. Let's increase the spacing to around 100. We got some random brush strokes. Next brush we are going to create is the shades. So using this shade brush, we'll be creating some shaded effect in your sketching. So we have used the same process to create out the brush. Just use the level options to reduce the background and use the eraser to erase out anything that is visible. Then after that, create a new brush, give it a name, shades, and then click OK. And your brush is ready. We'll do this, some settings in the brush settings and dynamics. Give it 40 by 10, then give a spacing around 25%. Under scattering, we have given 100% scattering. And we have added transfer effect as well with opacity 70%. Next, we'll follow the same steps to create out this dotted brush effect. So use the levels to increase the contrast, then eraser to erase out the extra shades, and then create out new brush that's dotted. And for this also, I will go to brush settings and over there keep the dynamics the same. Scattering, we have increased this counting to 2 and count jitter to 50%. Now to save all the brushes, I'll go to brush preset over here and go to preset manager. I'll select all of them, save set. Let's give it a name, PNCIL pencil, BRUSHES brushes, and save it. Done. And if I go to our file over here, here is our brushes. Let's say I want to delete everything. I'll just delete this out, delete brushes. Okay. And we don't have any brush now. And now if you want to load that brushes, you just go to brush, open preset manager and click on load and select the pencil brushes, open it, and done. So if you go and check out and over here, you got a folder pencil brushes and you got all these three brushes. So this way you can create your own brushes. You have to make sure that you know all the settings and you can do this adjustments with the settings as per your requirement in the design. So basically that's how you can use brushes in a dynamic way in your artwork. The second thing we are going to look is to create pattern. So we'll be creating a pencil sketches pattern in the next part, as this tutorial has become very long. So I have divided it into two parts. The next part will be fully concentrated on creating patterns in Photoshop, and these brushes and patterns are going to be used in our next tutorial, that is creating realistic sketches in Photoshop. And in that you can use any of your photograph and convert it into sketches effect. I hope you enjoy the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates for designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.